So I get asked, what do I drink when I celebrate? And that's a really good question because when you drink champagne as much as I do, and champagne is as big a part of your life as it is for me, you drink a lot of awesome champagnes all the time. But what do you drink when you have a special moment? And tonight I'm going to share with you a special moment that I've recently had and the champagne that I chose to reach for to celebrate that moment. This is the Francis Orban, the Hauts Beugnets. I'm Darryl, your champagne expert. Let's get bubbly. This is a 100% Meunier. This aged for 5 years. It has a dosage of 3 grams per liter, and it is a beautiful, beautiful presentation. So, enough talk. Let's dive into the Le Hauts Beugnets. So, as I've said before, what makes Francis Orban so special is that he took over the family business at age 19. Now, that's pretty bold. A 19-year-old taking over a 4-generation family business and continuing to run this with the family's tradition of Meunier. So roughly 90% of the vineyards are planted for the Meunier. And enough talk. Let's just get into this and this just get into it. Oh, here we go. Here we go. I'm always ready for this. Oh, there we go. There we go. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. No mistakes like the last time. And of course, a Gabrielle. So, the Le Hauts Beugnets, 50-year-old vines, small little plots, elevated. The parcels are elevated, as I mentioned. They're up on this hill, and it is just so beautiful. It is just so unique, and oh, I've been dying for this for so long. The area of Le Vignier is predominantly going to be limestone, some sandy soil, and very, very, very good for growing the Meunier. That is beautiful. Have a look at that. Look at that. Now that's eye candy. Let's get a nose of this. Ooh. I've been drinking a lot of Chardonnay lately, and I haven't had a Meunier in a little while, and this is the one that you want to break your fast on. Oh my God. It's so dark and so rich, and the fruit is crisp. It's heavy, it's complex, get some woody notes. There's some, I don't want to say roasted nuts, but there's a roasted something in there. There's a little bit of caramel. This is going to sound a little strange, but there's a hint of that baked apple, okay? There's a bit of baked apple. A smidgen of caramel, just a smidgen, and a little bit of vanilla. Wow, that is just amazing. It just keeps going. There's some honey. Ooh, there's a little bit of citrus. Some ginger. It is like layer upon layer upon layer. I mean, I can keep going on that nose. Ooh, but let's get the attack. Oh my God. This is one of those times where what you're getting on the palate and what you're getting on the nose are very similar, but in very different quantities and in very different amounts of power. The nose is extremely powerful. However, the palate, at least the attack, I'm going to give the palate in a second, but the attack is so elegant, so mature, that it almost throws you for a loop. It is so creamy, and there's a beautiful butteriness to it. And that comes from aging in oak. They age this in French oak barrels. I love that. And now you're gonna say, well, of course, why wouldn't they? But no, there's a lot of different barrels. Believe it or not, you can get them from Central Europe. You can get them, believe it or not, some houses use old American bourbon barrels. They use all sorts of barrels. But again, doubling down, keeping things real, French oak. Let's get that palate. Oh man, it's refreshing. It is refreshing. It is just like refreshing. Wow, it's been a while since I've been really, really moved by something, and I'm really moved by this. There's this beautiful clarity to it. All those flavors on the nose are still there. There's that caramel. There's that woody note. There's that honey. There's that brioche. That roasted. Know what I was getting? It's more of a brioche, more of a toasted bread. This is a chewy champagne. There's some density to it, and you're feeling the pulpy nature of the grape when you drink this. It is just so amazing. There's a small hint of that citrus, this orange. There's a little bit of orange there, and it's usually there's lemon or sometimes lime, but that's very orangey note. Wow, there's, oh man, I'm I need a second here. There's a really nice bright acidity to it, which I didn't get on the attack. There's a beautiful acidity to it. And as you know, Chardonnay is known for its acidity, but the Pinot Meunier and the Pinot Noir, they can as well. And this really depends on how they're grown and where in the terroir they're grown in. But I'm getting the acidity here, and that's what's balancing everything out. That's kind of what I was missing for a couple of seconds, was that all these parts were layered together so wonderfully. But it's that acidity that is just like wrapping them all up together and making them sing the same tune. On the finish, there's a little bit of minerality. There's a little bit of salinity, which I am very surprised at. It's very smooth, and that finish is just so magnificent. It is just, it's like an opera note that peaks and then just trails off into beautiful memory. And that's what this is. This is like an opera note, hitting it perfectly and then just trailing off and leaving you to wonder and ponder your place in the universe. Wow. I always question. Now, this is his product. This is his champagne. He made it. He knows what it is. He knows what to pair it with. And you got to go with that. And it's okay to have a different opinion. But you got to respect the opinion of the person who made it. And I was really excited to have a different opinion. You know, I was really excited to add to it, and I can't. Like, this is perfect for an aperitif. This is perfect as a standalone. This is perfect for a moment where you want to celebrate. And you want a bottle of champagne to share and celebrate. But to pair it with food, which this would pair, make that acidity, the salinity, the minerality, that fruitiness, that hint of orange, that hint of nutty brioche, that hint of caramel and vanilla, that ginger. Oh, this is ideal for food. And yes, I'm going to give you a recommendation on different foods, but no, we're going to stick with carpaccio. We're going to stick with scallops. We're going to stick with sushi. We're going to stick with simple, good seafood, okay? Because that's what this is going to really pair perfectly with. This is a champagne by a classical man producing a modern take on a classic champagne. This is a example of what tradition and heritage and forward thinking and modern can be. Like that's the best thing I can come up with. That's really what this is. This is I've got some champagnes that have gone back to the old ways, and my goodness, they are beautiful. I've got some champagnes that are literally 50 years in the future, and they are just like, wow, if this is the direction champagne is going, yeah, I'm in the right business. And you get these where the champagne is, yeah, I've got a grandfather, a dad, some brothers, some uncles who pioneered, and now it's mine. I took it over when I was 19, and now this is what I'm gonna go do with it. There's growth here, there's pride here. And I don't mean that in the negative. When I say pride, pride in family, pride in country, pride in culture, pride in champagne. That's here. You taste that. Wow. This is an experience. There's a bit of yeasty note to it coming through now. I know we're past the nose and that, but there's a yeasty note. Just keeps going. Unlike me. Thank you all again for another awesome experience. I hope you like the content. I hope you like what we're doing. I just want to make you guys happy. I just want to give everyone in the world a few minutes to enjoy life. A few minutes to sit down with a bottle of champagne and feel good about yourself. You know, feel good about the world, because it's a tough one. The world is tough out there. And we need all the breaks we can get. Like, subscribe. Like I said before in my previous videos, we're trying to hit 1,000 subscribers. Not to monetize, but literally just because I want to touch 1,000 people every time I produce a review. To share with you the emotion, the honesty, to share with you being human. Because we need that. We need to be people who can appreciate things, who can come together around things, and yeah. Sorry to be so like deep today. I don't know, but it is what it is. I'm human. I'm Darryl, the champagne expert. This is the best job a guy could have. That's because of all of you. Please, stay bubbly.